A day, 10 years ago, quite unexpectedly opened my eyes to the importance of human behavior in the world of AI. My mom and I went to pick up her new car, packed with all the latest tech like adaptive cruise control and so on. She sits into the car and what does she do? Turns off all the fancy tech features right away. Her reason was that she's been driving fine for years without these gadgets. Why should she use them now? That moment really got me thinking. It doesn't matter how sophisticated our technology is, we as humans can really make or break AI's potential. It also showed me that sometimes people aren't aware of all the benefits that technology brings and therefore end up ignoring it. While most people would have just Googled, "Why does my mom hate modern technology?" I decided to take it a bit further. I dove into years of working as a PhD researcher on human-AI interactions, then wrote a book on AI, and now I'm the co-founder of an AI company. I guess seeing my mom disable a few car features kind of defined my career. And today, I want to share with you some new research that I think reveals something extremely important about why you should team up with AI. A reason that goes beyond the usual praise for AI's speed or accuracy. And let me get one thing straight. I'm not here to repeat what you already know about AI's capability to outperform humans. Instead, I want to highlight a lesser known but incredible power of AI, its ability to help us reduce our cognitive biases, the thinking mistakes we all do without even noticing. Cognitive biases are like little glitches in our brain system. They trick us into making decisions that aren't always the best, despite having all the info needed to do better. Let me give you an example. This is me wondering if it's a good idea to hike the ridge in the back there. On that day, there was a windstorm, and we weren't sure if the weather would allow us to reach the summit. So on our way up, we crossed several hikers, and we asked them if it's possible to reach the summit. Every person told us to turn around. But I didn't learn from the new information, quite the opposite. Every time someone told me to turn around, I came up with new reasons why I should continue and continued my way up. If, however, someone would have told me that it's possible to reach the summit, I would have for sure trusted him fully. I think elaborating on how this story ended is not necessary at this point, but this is a textbook example of a cognitive bias called valence-dependent belief updating. When we receive good news, we update our beliefs quickly and effectively. When we receive bad news, we just ignore it. I'll admit it right away, if I had a dollar for every time I ignored good advice because I knew better, I could probably fund my own AI research lab by now. But I'm not the only one. We're all susceptible to these biases. So in the words of Nobel Prize winner Kahneman, we can be blind to the obvious and we're blind to our blindness. People make wrong decisions in predictable ways because of how our brains are wired. Unfortunately, these biases come at a hefty price tag. They don't just affect us on a personal level, leading to skipped health checks and poor financial choices. They also have profound societal impacts, contributing to major events like the 2008 financial crisis. So, if we want to make better decisions, we have to find ways to work around these biases. But the big question is how. Researchers have tried various methods to mitigate them. However, typically, they looked at situations where people got outside advice by human advisors, because traditionally, advisors were human. But what if this advice comes not from another human, but from AI? This is where our research comes into play. We set up an experiment where people got advice either by a human expert or by AI. But here's the twist. Both gave the exact same advice. What did our results show? Well, as expected, when people got advice from another human, their biases were very active, making them hold on to what they wanted to hear and ignore the rest. Pretty much like me hiking up that mountain. But when AI gave the exact same advice, they took in this information more equally and made less biased decisions. This suggests that in that hiking case, if I'd asked AI for advice, I might have ended up making a safer choice. We were pretty fascinated by these findings in our lab, so we repeated our experiments across different areas like stock investments and property purchases. And guess what? The results were consistent. People that got advice from AI made better decisions than people that got advice from another human, despite receiving identical information. This suggests that AI could be the partner we didn't know we needed when it comes to mitigating our cognitive biases. But what if we could take this partnership to the next level? From AI taking an advisory role to AI taking a collaborative role, where we delegate tasks to it much like we would delegate a task to a colleague. Again, delegation is often a struggle due to our biases. It feels risky to let go of a decision because we're wired to be slight control freaks. We love making our own decisions, even the ones we're not so good at. But again, this is in interactions with other humans. Let's enter AI. We put people in a scenario where they had to make a choice. Make their own decision, delegate to a human expert, or delegate to AI. And we found a clear pattern. When it came to working with other humans, our participants' inner control freaks were in full force. They made bad decisions and lost money just to make sure they remained in control over that decision. But when AI entered the picture, their biases took a break, and they made more logical delegation decisions. This resulted in more favorable outcomes for those people who could delegate to AI. Let me explain this finding with a real-world example. Managers tend to micromanage their teams, even if team members might have more specific skills for a certain task. Science shows that this results in inefficiencies and suboptimal outcomes. What we are saying now is, if that manager could delegate to AI instead of another human, he will do so sooner. His decision to delegate will be closer to rational decision-making, which ultimately is a huge benefit for the company. But how come, all of a sudden, people act more rationally when their partner is AI? It all comes down to our perception of whether we think someone is capable of acting with their own intentions. For humans, we know they can have their own intentions. This triggers our biases. But for AI, things are different. We perceive it as a tool without its own agenda. This flips a switch in our brains. Our subconscious defense is lower, which fundamentally changes how we make decisions. Given these findings, we wanted to test how far we could take them. From research, we know that stress and pressure can amplify our biases. Think about it. Have you ever had to make a big decision when the clock was ticking? Or when the consequences were severe? It's tough, right? So repeated our experiments in high-stake environments, like during an economic downturn. We wanted to see if AI could make an even bigger improvement to human decision-making in those situations. And indeed, it did. In those tense times, when people could delegate to another human, their stress amplified their biases. They made even worse decisions and lost even more money than before. But when they could delegate to AI instead, their stress impacted their decision-making much less, and they were more willing to actually delegate. Let me explain this finding again with the example of the manager who doesn't want to delegate. Now, think of the situation where his company faces severe challenges. It might even go bankrupt. Now he's even less inclined to delegate anything to another person because now, more than ever, he has to remain in control over this decision. This means even bigger inefficiencies for the company. In such high-stakes situations, AI is transformative. With increasing stress, the difference in a manager's willingness to delegate to AI versus other humans increases. While his tendency to delegate to another human diminishes, reliance on AI remains more robust and closer to rational decision-making. This improvement in human decision-making is crucial for a company, especially during those tense times. But it is also crucial for our personal lives. So, what's the big takeaway here? Teaming up with AI can help us sidestep our cognitive biases, even more so in moments of intense stress or pressure, meaning AI makes us sharper thinkers when we really need it. This underscores the immense value of AI as a partner in our daily lives, as these biases shape every aspect of our decision making. So what am I not saying? I'm not saying we should blindly trust AI or that we should replace humans with AI. But I am saying that we should use AI to become better decision makers. It's about how AI complements our emotional and irrational human nature and how we can become better together. So I invite you to rethink situations in your daily life where you might benefit from better decision making because your biases are kicking in. In those moments, reach out to AI and see how it changes your behavior. Because just as those car features could have enhanced my mom's driving capabilities, AI can enhance your decision-making capabilities without you even noticing. Thank you.